Welcome back to Weekend Out. My name is Gaurav. Now, to suna hoga. Now, this is the time when I introduce you to a great restaurant and I am ready with it. We are at the heart of the Dubai International Financial Center. And I think DIFC can also be called the Dubai International Food Center because this place has some amazing restaurants. In fact, sometimes it's very difficult to choose where you want to eat, but we don't have that problem right now. I know exactly what I want you to see because, you know, if you're looking for Indian at DIFC, Bombay Baro is the place to go.
The concept of Bombay Baro is culinary journey across India. We showcase our unique flavors to our customers. We have selected menu across the states of India, basically from the south, from the east, from the west. The interiors is it's layered into two layers. We have the indoor and the outdoor dining with us. Outdoor dining where the customers can enjoy the climate outside, cool, pleasant outside.
Now the menu here is very, very interesting, and I say interesting because this is a very refreshing menu. It's got dishes from all over India, and the way they've explained their dishes and the way they've named them, it looks like they've added their own twist to a lot of them. So I have actually gone ahead and ordered some of the most interesting ones. So we're finally now ready to eat what I've ordered. Now this is the Rajputana Murg Sula Kebab. Now this has got a little bit of a history, but I'm going to tell you that once I've taken a bite. Nice chunky pieces of chicken look beautiful, torched at the table right in front of me. Now there's butter all over them. This is a good recipe. Okay, here we go.
Putara Murg Sula, it's basically your spicy kebab, and believe me, it's a burst of flavors in your mouth.
Rajputana Murg Sula is a kebab cooked to perfection.
So the kebabs are absolutely mouth-watering.
Tender pieces of chicken, the torching here has also added a little bit of a charred flavor to it. And the beauty of this is that they've actually done this in the shikar masala. Now, so there's actually a story behind these Rajputana Sula kebabs. The story is that this is the way the Rajputana warriors used to make their kebabs. So, you know, while they were at war, they didn't have mixers, obviously. So they would coarsely grind the masalas, whatever was available at that time. And then they would just marinate their chicken and place it on skewers and make it. That's exactly how they've done it. Beautiful taste, great flavors.
Rajputana Murg Sula, it's one of the best chicken kebab I've ever had.
Now this is the Kashmiri Naan kebab. Now this looks really good when it's served at your table. It's a 12-inch kebab placed on a nice looking wet with butter naan. This looks really good. I am going to cut a piece out. Oh, you can see this, it's nice and tender. It's already broken. I didn't really have to do much. And I'm actually gonna have it like how a naan kebab should be had.
Kashmiri naan kebab, the way it's presented only, it's beautiful and it's one of the best kebabs I've eaten in Dubai.
The Kashmiri naan kebab is really succulent and a perfect way to start a meal.
And this is such a beautiful bite. Now this is a mix of two different flavors completely. So here's a mildly spiced Sikh kebab, a minced meat kebab, rich in flavors. And then there's the mild flavor of the saffron that this naan has been glazed with. It's a beautiful combination. Mm.
The Kashmiri naan kebabs are so juicy, they literally melt in your mouth.
So this chutney is called Doon Chetin. Now this is a very special Kashmiri chutney, and Doon actually means walnut and Chetin means chutney. Now the thing is that this is a nutty, spicy, creamy sort of chutney all at the same time. And this is specially eaten with meats. Now this combination is something you're going to love.
The Kashmiri naan kebab is one of my favorite dishes here. It has the right balance of spices and I highly recommend it.
So mid-meal, I need a little bit of a palate cleansing, and I'm going to do that with something called the mango masti. But it's not just called mango masti, it's called the mango masti pauwa. And, well, I can't explain to you what the pauwa means on TV, but those who know, know. The The third dish is the aam papad paneer. Now, this is quite a unique dish. It looks very unique as well. And this is also served with a lotus stem crisp. That's very interesting. Chaliye, let's dig into this.
Aam papad paneer is a unique combination of sweet and is tangy. I'm not big on vegetarian food, but this is really something that I definitely want to try.
Aam papad paneer is tangy and a must try.
Total delight for all the vegetarians.
I've got to say, this is so beautiful in its taste. It's got nicely done paneer and it's covered with this aam papad sauce. To be honest, I've really not had aam papad sauce before. As a child, I've had a lot of aam papad, and I think it's what we have given to the world. Like the Italians probably gave us sun-dried tomatoes, we gave them sun-dried mango. If you've never tried it, you're missing out on something. This is just beautiful.
The aam papad paneer had a nice balance of sweet and sour flavors, and probably the best paneer I've had out of India.
The mains, I'm having a toddy shop fish curry. Now, I'm just hoping that you guys know what's a toddy shop, and that's the only time you realize that this is actually essentially a simple happy meal. And just to make things clear for the record, this is not toddy, this is a drink called Pink City. Okay, so here it is, some fish curry and rice. There's nothing better than this combination. Some rice, and here you go, some beautiful looking red in color fish curry.
Toddy shop fish curry takes me literally back to Kerala. It's so nice and coconutty. Oh, yummy.
The toddy shop fish curry had the right balance of flavors with a perfectly cooked piece of fish.
This is the taste that you want from your fish curry, and that's the reason why this fish curry is so popular at toddy shops, because this is exactly what heaven tastes like. The curry gets its taste from three main ingredients. One is actually the red chili. The other is the tamarind that's used. Now, this is the Kodampulli tamarind. Now, this is also known as the Malabar tamarind. Now, this has a aftertaste when it's dried. It's got an aftertaste, something close to what a jamun would leave in your mouth, right? But this, used in this curry, is just heaven. Amazing. You will love this. Of course, they've used the sea bass here. That is so good. This does look like a kulfi, but to be honest, this is a kulfa. And if you haven't heard of a kulfa, then probably you've never been to Amritsar. It's one of the dishes that you must have while you're in Amritsar. It's also known as the big brother of the kulfi. But slightly different from a kulfi faluda, although it's got both these ingredients. So here you've got some kulfi, you've got some faluda, you've got some rabri, and you've got some rose syrup, and you've got a generous sprinkle of nuts. But the proof of the pudding is always in eating it. So here we go.
If you're a sweet tooth, you definitely need to try the kulfa, Amritsari kulfa.
The rose flavor on the Amritsari kulfa is the cherry on top.
The Amritsari kulfa, the last thing what is just needed for your meal.
Can anyone go wrong with this combination of kulfi and rabri? I don't think so.
The Amritsari kulfa is a perfect end to this hearty meal. And this is like a proper finisher. This is what you want to have, and you're done with your proper Indian meal.
Well, I may have come to the dessert in just one main course, but you don't have to. There are a lot of other things that I recommend in the menu. Take a look.